Assalamu alaikum, everybody. Welcome to the second installment of the Zoom In on the Halal Metropolis. My name is Jenna Shami with the Halal Metropolis team. For those who are new to the series, Zoom In on the Halal Metropolis is a video series where we take a closer look on how the Muslim communities of Southeast Michigan are coping with the COVID-19 pandemic. For returning viewers, thank you for joining us yet again. Today, we'll be speaking to Mariam, a nurse at Henry Ford Detroit and founder and CEO of Med Hijabs, which is a medical hijab for mask wearing and stethoscope accessibility. Mariam, thank you for joining us. How are you doing?
I'm good. Thank you for having me. How are you doing?
Alhamdulillah, I'm doing good. Thank you for asking. So Med Hijabs, when I found out about this, I was so excited. I was like, this is such a cool initiative. But before we begin, I just wanted to ask you, like, how has it been working as a nurse during this pandemic?
Yes. So at the beginning of the pandemic, I was a phlebotomist working through it because I was working as a phlebotomist while in nursing school. So even from that perspective, it was kind of tough because I was oftentimes in and out of patient rooms, the same as everyone else. I was working in the ICUs trying to help them with blood draws. I was working on the south side of Chicago. So it was like 90% of our patients were COVID patients. So it was tough. It was tough on everyone, on all the staff working in the hospital. But we all worked together. We all made sure we were taking care of one another. And, you know, like we got through the toughness of it. And I think now going into like this second wave, we kind of know what we're doing. So now it's like I'm kind of going through it with my experience as a phlebotomist, but now as a nurse. So it's been okay. Yeah.
That's good that you have like that sense of camaraderie with your fellow nurses, and now you guys know what to do going into like the second wave. Mm-hmm. So now with Med Hijabs, like what motivated you to start it?
Yeah, so the hospital I was working at, we would get nightly emails about what's new, what do we have to, like what's going to change in the next day. So I had gotten the email saying, well, starting tomorrow, we have to wear masks while on the hospital grounds. And as someone that wears a hijab at work, like I already knew, like, great, like this is going to be so hard, because usually I would tie the strings of it behind my hijab to have it, my mask on. And then to take it off, I would rip it off. But if I'm only getting one mask a day, I was like, how am I going to do this? And then I have to switch from my medical mask to my N95 throughout the day. So I was like staying up all night thinking, how am I going to wear my mask? How am I going to take it on and off easily? What am I going to do? And I like thought about it all night. I thought about it on my drive into work. And then it just kind of hit me that I was like, well, what if I sew something to the side of my hijab and I could hook my mask onto that? Maybe that would work. So like the whole day while I'm at work, I'm just like in my head thinking like, how am I going to sew it? What am I going to do? So then I get home and I take one of my like two-piece hijabs that I usually wear to work. And I have like my box of buttons, you know, like the misfit buttons that you get from your clothing and things. So I found like two that match and I sewed one onto each side. And I was like, let me see if this works. So then I wore it the next day at work and I was thinking, and it was like seamless. It was so great. I was like taking it on and off and like, I can't believe this worked. I was so excited about it. And then I had come home and I was like really thinking about it, because I'm like, what is out there for us? You know, like what is out there for us to do? How are other women in the healthcare field doing this? And I really thought about it. And I was like, what else could we do? How else could I design this? How can I uplift this design to be something that is like useful and is something that is like practical and that it like looks good and it looks seamless to like other women that are in healthcare? Because I know there's a lot of us out there. I know there's a lot of us in the field. So that's kind of where it was like, I think I have to do this. I really think I have to pursue this and figure it out.
Well, that's amazing. Cause honestly, like it just like, I was so surprised that there wasn't something like that out there, you know?
Right. Yeah.
So basically like once you had this idea, like how did it become into like a full fledged like company? Like how did it go from the idea to the reality of it?
Yeah. So because of that too, I knew what was out there, right? I was a nursing student. I was working as a phlebotomist. I knew what was out there, even as far as like stethoscope accessibility. I've bought in other hijabs that were stethoscope accessibility. And like one of them, I'm like, I don't even know how to wrap this. I don't even know how to use it. I was like having to like cut them and adjust them just to make them fit right to where I'm like, this isn't practical. So I knew there was a problem. I knew other people had this issue because the other woman I know, we talk about this. What do you do that works? How do you make it work?
Yeah.
And if you go on YouTube, you see all these YouTube videos, how to have your hijab stethoscope accessible. So I knew if I'm going to do this, I have to do this right. I have to do this to where it's like stethoscope and mask accessible. I have to make it to where it's functional. I have to make it to where it's going to work. So I sketched out what I wanted. I like was like, okay, if I'm going to do this, I have to be serious. So I started writing on a business plan. And then I wrote like 4 pages of how I envisioned all this coming together, of how I wanted it all to be. And I thought about it and I thought about it, and I'm not a risky person. I don't do things like this. I'm very much like by the book. I don't like to do something that's like extra. And I know everyone has a side hustle now, but I'm like, no, that's fine. I just want to go to work and come home and not think about anything else. Yeah. But the more I thought about it, I just knew like I had to do this. Like there was just a feeling inside me that was like, you have to pursue this. So I have a friend who went to the Chicago Institute of Art, and I was living in Chicago at the time. So I'm like, I know she probably knows a designer. So I reached out to her and I said, do you know any designer? This is my idea. This is what I'm trying to do. Do you know anyone that I could work with? So she connected me with Jamie, who owns Production Mode. She's a designer in Chicago. And I met with her. I was like, this is my sketch. This is my idea. This is what I'm trying to make. And she just took me under her wing. She like showed me everything there was to know, like from how to get my fabric, from how to get my like hooks, what kind of hooks to use, like how to get, like how we're going to stitch it, what different things. Like she taught me everything there was to teach me, even from like a production standpoint. She like got me in touch with a production team. Like she just completely just took me under her wing in every sense of the matter. And I was just like, oh, like wide-eyed, teach me everything you can, writing everything down when we were in meetings. And we had our first sample, and I tried it on and I was like in tears because I'm like, this is like, I did this, like I made this. And like the first sample was just about perfect. There was like one slight adjustment we had to make. And she was like, this doesn't happen. Like we usually have like 3-4 samples that we have to make before it could be something like usable. But I knew exactly what I needed. I knew what I needed it to be. I knew where everything needed to be on the hijab. So it just, everything kind of fell into place. And subhanAllah, I really feel like it was like God looking out for me, because I was starting this in the middle of COVID. Like even small businesses that were already open were struggling. Like there was like issues with me getting fabric in on time, with me getting someone that's still working, a production team that was still working, because a lot of places they couldn't spread people out enough to work safely. So like things like that, that most people were having like hiccups with, like subhanAllah, it was like one thing after another, things just fell into place. And I took that as a sign of like, this is what I'm meant to do. This is what I need to continue doing. So we kept going through it. I was like working as a phlebotomist in nursing school and working on this at the same time. And subhanAllah, it was like, I launched it in August, the beginning of August. I did pre-sale. And then I started sending out like my first round of orders like the week before I graduated. So I like set everything in, then took my final, and then graduated. Wow. Like sent out all the hijabs. And it was crazy, subhanAllah, but it's still amazing to me. And it still feels surreal that people will come and talk to me about it, like at events or things, or that people will like know that that's what I did. And I'm like, yeah, like this is, it's really, subhanAllah, it's really surreal to me still.
No, honestly, like, it's amazing. Like, I'm telling you, when I heard about this, I was like, this is such a cool, like, thing. I was like, no, I was like, I've never seen this before. And I was like, I know a few people were talking about it. And I was like, this is just such a game changer. And then the fact that you were able to do it and, like, come into full fruition, like, during the pandemic, like, especially, like, as you said, like, there were, you thought, like, a lot of people were out of business. So, like, I just think I'm so happy for you that worked out and all that.
Alhamdulillah. I'm just so thankful for it all.
I'm thankful for you for making it, honestly. So basically, how's it going right now with Med Hijabs? Like, how has the feedback been? I know you mentioned that a little bit.
Yeah. So at the beginning, I would get DMs from a lot of people that were like, this is amazing. Like kind of what you said, this is a game changer. I had one person that said, She just started clinicals and she was really struggling and she wasn't sure how she was going to use her hijab. And she was considering taking off her hijab. And she said, then the next day I saw your ad. And I was, and I just was like having chills the entire day. And I was like, subhanAllah, subhanAllah, like who thinks of something like that? You know, like who, like me, just me, like me little like lady doing these things like that it like inspired someone or that it made them feel that their hijab wasn't limiting to them, which is the biggest thing for me because we're in every field, right? Mm-hmm. If we're not advocating for ourselves, if we're not like doing these, like making hijabs like this or making our, like being accessible to it, like who else is going to, who else would advocate for us, you know?
Right, right.
No, but subhanAllah. So we, we've sent hijabs to 4 continents so far. So no, we've been in Australia, we've been in Asia, we've been in Europe, and we've been off like North America, Canada area. So I had, I just had like a big order, like I had 100 hijabs that were sent to Asia. So that was kind of crazy too. Another thing too, it was like a DM of someone that wanted hijabs. And it was with Mufti Mehdi that he needed them for like their women's group and all of their friends and stuff that are in it. So they wanted all these hijabs. And I'm like, okay, this is really happening.
Yeah.
And even just every time I get a little country, I have a globe and I like mark it on my little globe of the countries that we've sent hijabs to. And it's subhanAllah, it's just, I'm so thankful for it. I'm so
Honestly. Yeah. Oh my God. Wow. 4 continents. I did not know that. That's so cool. It's
kind of when so I know. So that's what's crazy. So when it, like, we've been to Australia, Finland, Ireland, the UK, Belgium, Malaysia, Singapore, and then Canada and the US.
So cool. Oh my God. Alhamdulillah. Honestly, it's so amazing. Wow. So now as it keeps growing, like what are your plans for the future? Like, where do you see Medhijabs like going?
Yeah. So we've had 2 rounds of production so far. So with every round, I'm just trying to get feedback because it's not like I could send out 100 hijabs, you know, and have like a sample feedback from people. So I'm getting feedback as we're going. So right now I'm working with a designer in Lansing to like take my original design and like make it even better. Like, let's get all of the things that people had said or that things didn't work or things I could adjust. So I've been working on that, trying to make sure that my design is like flawless and perfect as it can be. So I've been working on that. Again, with COVID, right, we have like a lot of like slowing down and things. So like I ordered fabric back in September and I'm still waiting on it. So really? Inshallah, yes, inshallah, by the time the fabric gets here, the design will be done and I could like have like another round of production. I really want to get into like surgical OR hijabs. I really want to work on that, but it's taking a lot of research and I just need to make sure that like what I'm doing is by all standards that it needs to be.
Right.
Because I know there's like other things out there. Like when I was in the OR, I had like a beard hood that I had to use. And I mean, it just looks awful. I'm not going to lie to you. It just looks horrible. So I really want to work on making something that like fits right and looks good and is made for us. That is like a hijab. I know there's other ones that have been made. I know there's one in the UK that a student had made one, but it's not something that you could like readily buy. So I would just want something to where it's like, hey, if I know I'm having an OR rotation, let me buy a box of it and make sure I have some on hand when I need to be in the OR type mm-hmm. of thing. Yeah. Or like, yeah, scrub tops too. That's something I would love to work on next to get them like a little bit longer, a little bit more modest because I find that I have to like oversize my scrubs just so I still am modest and I still have like everything covered that needs to be. So that would be something in the future I would love to work on too.
That's amazing. Oh my God, I'm so excited for you. So I see that you're wearing your Medhijab. Can you show us like how it works and like all of everything?
Yeah. So I'm wearing the universal because my stethoscope is at work in my locker. So I was like, I can't show you that. So if you just have your mask, so you put it over and then you hook it. My hook is right here and my hook is back here. Sorry. Okay. And then it's hooked on.
Wow. Wow, it's so easy. And then with the other one, you have the slits that you
Yeah, so then you take it off easily too. So then the other one, it has a slit here for your stethoscope. So I've been using it at work, and it's just so easy because even with my mask on, I'm able to use my stethoscope and I don't even think about it. And
So nice.
like, I know that's not the case. There's so many times that we're like adjusting or we're doing things, and I'm like, subhanAllah, like every time I get to use it, I do like a little happy dance inside my head, and I'm like, this is just great.
That's amazing, honestly. I'm so excited for you and for the future. And thank you for showing us your hijab.
Thank you so much for having me and letting me share this with all of you guys.
So thank you again, Mariam, for speaking with us today. I absolutely love this initiative. As I said before, this is really a breakthrough for the Muslim community. So thank you for creating it. And if you're a listener and you have a story you would like to share with us or be featured on the Zoom In series, please fill out the form linked below. And I'm wishing everybody safety and health. Until next time, assalamu alaikum.
Assalamu alaikum.